Only you could almost be late for your own goodbye.
I'm sorry I rushed across the street.
Before we say farewell, the staff of the Today Show just wanted to send you a little message. Take a look.
Memories matter. They are who we are. And Katie, you've made a million of those memories for all of us.
In sports, they say, you know, big players play big in big games. And for us, Katrina was about as big as it gets. And she was remarkable.
It was 2004 at the Democratic Convention in Boston, and we were standing outside. It had just rained, and we heard that John Kerry and John Edwards were going to be coming by. So what did Katie do? She kicked off her shoes, ran through the mud, and grabbed them. She got the exclusive interview.
I appreciate it. I know. Well, you know what? I had to jump around to try to grab you guys.
As a producer, it's just incredible to watch her in action. She could be having her hair blow dried, makeup applied, changing her clothes, and getting briefed for an interview with the President of the United States. And somehow, she retains all that information in a matter of 3 minutes.
She's the girl who borrows your notes in school and does better on the test than you do.
You never know what's going to happen with Katie when she's on the shoot.
Sometimes behind the scenes, there can be a lot of mayhem. And I was producing a shoot once where everyone was fighting. And as soon as Katie walked in the room, everybody just smiled.
She always kept you on your game.
What I love about Katie is that she treats everyone like they're her next door neighbor.
She likes to share. If you're wearing a scarf that she likes, she wants to wear that outside.
What I think people should know about Katie, the behind the scenes Katie, is that she's very funny.
She's just as fun on camera as she is off.
Personally, I'm gonna miss seeing her every single morning. It was like, you know, emotional connection.
So we have this really wonderful relationship, and that's the stuff I'll remember really well.
Hey, Katie, for the last few years, I've had the opportunity to work with one of the best who's ever sat in that seat, and for that, I will be forever grateful.
Good luck, Katie. Bye.
Katie, goodbye and good luck.
We'll miss you, and good luck.
Miss you. Bye-bye.
Good luck, Katie.
You've been a first-class friend and colleague. I'll really miss you. Thank you, Katie. Love you.
Be happy, Katie.
It won't be the same without you.
Katie, it's been a great run.
Good luck, Katie, from your graphics team. Bye, Katie.
And here we are on the steps in Rockefeller Plaza. We've been joined by our entire New York staff here on the steps.
Can I just walk down and look at everybody?
Sure, go ahead. Also, as you look, though, Katie, I want you to know that we're also being joined via satellite from the people at our bureaus in Los Angeles, in Washington, D.C.
They have a...
Goodbye, Katie.
In Chicago.
Chicago. Chicago. Panda, Joe, Panda.
There they are.
In London.
Cheers.
People in our control room downstairs, Katie.
Hi, everybody.
All
and thank
preparing
you
to
so
say
much.
Goodbye. Can I also say, what do you get for the girl who has everything? I want you to just look over here and see what Martin Sarr, a very talented artist, has done with 335 pictures of the people you have worked with over the years here at NBC. A collage or a mosaic, if you will, with all of their faces, all of them wishing you well. And if you look just to your right, melting slightly is a cake by the lovely David Carmichael that we can all cut up and share in a second. Exactly.
Oh, thank you all so
come on back
much
over
for
here.
Everything.
Because for the last couple of weeks now, we've been talking about your impact on television and morning news, and we want to end this morning by talking just about your impact on our lives and the fact that you've been a great colleague and, more importantly, a terrific friend. And you're going to go on to great heights. We know that. I hope you know that we're all going to be wishing you well, even if quietly. And we wish you the best in every single aspect of your life. We love you and we're going to miss you. Cheers.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone. I couldn't ask for a nicer, more wonderful send-off. So I'm going to be kissing you all day long. So I hope I didn't get makeup on everyone. Thank you. And to everyone in TV land, thanks so much.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Dirty window, let the sun illuminate the words that you
mission to not make mistakes. But I can't live that way, no. Staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate.
Love you. Congratulations.
Tomorrow on Today, it's summer and we're outside on the plaza every day. Kicking things off, American Idol's Taylor Hicks and Catherine McPhee. Together live in concert. Then Friday, country superstar Brad Paisley. Great music, good times, summer on the plaza. Only on Today on NBC.
Warning flags. Hurricane season begins today, and government officials everywhere are telling residents get ready or else. Tragic mix-up. 5 weeks after a horrible car accident, a grieving family finds out their daughter is actually alive, while another learns the daughter they thought had survived is dead. How could that happen? And the great outdoors. We're spending the summer outside, and we can't wait to show off our new digs today, Thursday, June 1st, 2006.
From NBC News, this is Today with Matt Lauer and Ann Curry, live from Rockefeller Plaza.
And good morning. Welcome to a brand new chapter of Today on a Thursday morning. I'm Matt Lauer, and we've got a lot of exciting changes to talk about.
We do.
But first, let me welcome you. Ann Curry is going to be spending a lot of time this summer sitting next to me, along with Campbell Brown and Natalie Morales, all getting ready for Meredith Vieira to join the Show in September. But we're going to have a lot of fun this
That's
summer.
That's right. The big countdown to sweet Meredith's arrival has just begun today. And also, we've got Baton Girls all in between.
Much more than Baton Girls, and we're happy to have you
happy
here.
Happy to be here. Anyway, meantime, Matt, as you mentioned, we're not in our old Studio 1A anymore. We're not in Kansas anymore because Studio 1A is getting a well-deserved facelift, maybe even a little Botox that we're not watching. We've moved across the street to our new summer home right here on the plaza, and we're going to tell you and show you much more about it coming up a little later. But coming up in a moment, the start of hurricane season, is the government and the public ready? We're going to be asking the head of FEMA this morning.
Also, had a mystery in South Carolina. Who killed a Clemson sophomore with her own bikini top? Authorities are sounding like they're close to arresting a suspect. We're going to have the latest on that story. Plus, a big admission from Prince Albert of Monaco today. For the second time, he's had to come forward to say that he's fathered a child after a brief fling. The girl, actually a teenager, now living in California. We'll tell you more about that story as well.
That's right. She's just 14 years old, and by the way, her middle name is Grace. Meantime, guys, is it too good to be true? Women who will be cleaning up your home with no strings attached. We'll tell you all about that coming up. And also, a special treat to celebrate our move outdoors. We've got American Idol winner Taylor Hicks and runner-up Catherine McPhee live on our plaza for a huge concert this morning. Look at the crowd. They're ready for them, and we'll be bringing them to them coming up on our program today.
All right, we look forward to seeing both of them. But first, let's get the headlines of the morning. And for that, we turn to Natalie Morales, who's over at the news stool this morning. You look like you're going to give a commencement address there.
My fellow Americans. Yeah. I'm going to feel like I'm ready to give a speech.
It's
thanks.
Good, though.
Matt and Ann, good morning, everyone. Well, the U.S. is hoping European allies will join in pressuring Iran to stop enriching uranium. Today, Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice is in Austria, and NBC's chief foreign affairs correspondent Andrea Mitchell is traveling with her. Andrea, good morning.